Go live. Let's go live, Des.
Go live. The only time I've cleaned my poll since I've had it.
This is it. We're live. We're back.
Sorry. Well, if you are, if we are on, good morning. It is good morning, isn't it? Oh, no, it's not. Yeah, it is.
We've got a minute to spare, haven't we?
Good morning. And welcome to the Superium poll Q&A.
Yeah, the special.
Special. It is special. It took my motorbike out in the rain. So I can actually move in the garage. That's how special this is.
This is a special one. So everyone's been asking for the Q&A back, Des.
Yeah.
And I kind of said we'd start in January.
Yeah.
After Christmas, because we're both very busy at the minute.
Yeah.
But the polls got launched last week in shops. So I thought it'd be perfect. If anyone's looking to buy one, anyone's got any questions about one, maybe bought one and I don't know what elastic to put in them and all that kind of stuff. Perfect chance in to have a little chat.
Yeah, lots of questions about top kits. I mean, top kits is probably one of the, not just about the poles, but, you know, what top kits, what elastics can you run through the actual kit? And I know that, you know, even down to the potting kit, you know, how do you put your pot on? How do you put the little bracket on that takes your pot? So any questions like that, just get everything. As long as, you know, if there's any other questions as well, we will try and answer. But
we want to keep the poll.
I haven't just got my poll out there. I've actually got it out because it got soaking wet over the weekend. And I normally let them go mouldy before I clean them. And I thought, while I was speaking to Joe on the phone this morning, I thought, I'll get my holder out. I've actually got it, my holder facing me on an old roller and it's trying to dry out. But I thought I'd give me pole a bit of a clean. Just got a bit of kitchen towel. It's nice actually when you get when your pole's actually sopping wet from the weekend.
Yeah.
It's a really good time to clean it because everything's like all the mud and.
Yeah. Obviously, I've not fished a match with my XS90 since before the baby was born anyway. And the last time I fished was with slop. So that's going to be nice when I get that out, isn't it?
Worms. I mean, you only got to do a little bit of fish with worms.
And when you put it in your cupping pot and you chop them up when you go in your bag of wheat later and it's...
They're wrecked. Yeah, mouldy. I've managed to catch it before it's gone mouldy. But it only takes a couple of days and it's mouldy. So that's why it's out there. It's drying out. I've actually just cleaned the outside. I've not cleaned the inside because it is quite a new pole.
There's a lot of people saying, obviously, it's nice to see you back. There's hang on, Gareth. It's here. We've drawn PSG.
Look, I'm still back the old.
We win the group. We get PSG. Chelsea.
He rose.
Second in the group and get Lille. Fix. Total fix, that.
Don't interest me at all, football.
Well, you're in the minority there, Desmond.
I know.
Right, so there's an odd question. Not many questions coming through, but the first one that's come through is Mark wants to know, Silverfish top twos obviously don't have a side puller in them. They do have the wrap though, gents, for anyone watching. Do you think it's better for him to drill out for the side puller or use a bottom puller?
For me personally, this is one thing we've spoke about. You know, when we go to these meetings, all right, mate, I just got the postman dropping some off. This is live, so this does happen. Thanks.
Okay, thanks
very much.
Cheers, mate. Cheers. I'll tell you what that is. Match fishing calendar, because I've just got one.
It is. Should I get it out?
Yeah, get it out. Your mate's on the cover.
Who's that?
Have a look. I am texting because I'm trying to keep up with some questions coming in. So,
DHP, you're right, Joe.
Thought so. I've seen that envelope.
You are, look, Mr. Power himself. What a bit of timing that is.
That's a bit.
Get that through the post. We were starting to talk about polls.
Unbelievable advertising for the old DHP boys.
He's ugly, isn't he? Isn't he really? I used to be like that when I was his age.
I can't say me and you are lookers, are we?
I'll put him down, face down, on that cardboard box. Anyway, going back to the more serious stuff, a match kit for me, and we spoke about it at meetings. You know, shall we fit a side puller? And I just don't want it personally. I prefer the normal sort of old style out the bottom puller kit. I've got one here. Show you. That's it. I just prefer it because when you're fishing, especially when you're fishing like quite a shallow venue, that side puller can get in the way. It can it can sort of like, you know, you start jamming the little bead on your hand on the way out and on the way in. And I think for a match kit, when you're catching lots and lots of roach and things like that, it can just get in the way of what you're doing. So personally, we left it. We have put the collar round, the reinforced collar, which you can see there. So if you want to, you can drill it out and put your side puller up, your little side bit in there if you like. But personally, for me, I just prefer that. Even though you have to put your number three section in that, I think it's pretty easy.
Still a good system though, isn't it?
Yeah, we just somehow we left it and just give you the option. At least, you know, there is like a reinforced area on there. So all you've got to do is buy yourself a roller puller kit and then drill it out and put it in.
Yeah, because so, there's other advantages, isn't there? Like if you are an angler who likes to fish with a tip in the water on a river, obviously having that hole in the side can actually draw water in your pole, can't it?
With that puller in, the old original puller, it does actually stop the water from going in and, you know, pushing the air out, basically.
Yeah.
So there's a couple of advantages. It's just down to like a canal angle, you know. Even though a lot of us don't go canal fishing anymore,
it's nice to give them the option, though, isn't it?
Nice to give them the option. I mean, most of us who go on commercials now are really fishing for carp and F1s. I know the silvers make play a part in the winter time, but if you think about your canal anglers and stuff, they wouldn't want a side puller. It would just get in the way when you're catching maybe 100 to 200 fish. And you're actually shipping back past that roller puller side kit, it's going to get in the way. So that's why we've done it.
Yeah.
But I do prefer it for that reason, because it just doesn't get in the way when you're shipping in and out.
Nice. James Stokes says, what's the best to stop your section sticking together? Now, they shouldn't. Our poles don't actually stick that bad, do they? But
I mean, obviously, it's like my pole, but this morning when I got it out, it's absolutely sopping wet. You know, what I do, if I do go fishing over the weekend, such, or obviously I'm out a lot more than most people, as we know, if it is wet, I get it out on my roller and try and let it dry out, because it's the suction of the dampness. That's what causes it. Really, to stop it happening, you've got to try and keep the joints dry, because that's what makes it. It's like a vacuum pump. It does go in there sometimes. And I've never really had any problems with our response poles, any of the response poles.
It tends to happen when they're worn out, doesn't it? Not our poles, but poles in general, when they go on, slide on too far.
You just got to go a bit careful, you know, just go in, a little tweak. It normally happens to me when I've got like a tree behind me
and I've
walloped some on the way back, and you think, Christ, and then after the match, some stuck. Because it is, you imagine that, it's like being hit with a mallet.
It's like serious, isn't it?
Yeah, it is a proper whack. So, anyway, just dry your joints out. I've heard of people using a candle wax, maybe a little bit of silicone, you know, just normal silicone, just to go over your, you know, it all depends what some people clean there. I just clean my pole with soapy water, warm soapy water. I don't put anything on it. I know some people use like baby wipes because it gives it that little soft,
you know. Baby soft.
Yeah, baby soft touch, if you like. So if you want to do that, little baby wipe. I know I used to say when I went fishing with Sean Ashby in the World Champs, he used to use these little baby wipes, because he just said it leaves a little bit of a film on it, so it ships in and out really easily. But personally for me...
Come on, Sean, that's a bit...
Well, you know what they're like.
I'm not going to say it, because I'll get called names.
That area of the country... Yeah, just give it a clean, dry it out. It's drying it out, it's the main thing. And don't get, obviously, forcing it on. It doesn't need to be.
You do get them stuck together. What's the best way to get them apart?
Three
of you, don't you?
You need three people. Get two of you literally that far, a meter from the joint, both ends. The guy in the middle just waggle, you know, literally goes around like that. And you will see it within a few seconds. You'll see it coming apart in the dampness. And it's not always damp. Most of the time, because there's a bit of water gone in there, it's jammed up, and just do it really, really nice.
Disclaimer, you need to do it gently, don't you?
The bigger the sections, the smaller you've got to do it, because the bigger the sections haven't got the play like the smaller sections. If you get like your 11 meter stuck, your 10 meter bit, your 30 meter bit, that's when you've got to go really, really slowly. Because I see people, they're like that. Yeah, that's like
danger zone, isn't it?
Right on your small sections, because they'll give, but your big sections, you know, obviously when you're playing a carp, you can see what happens with a pole. As it gets near the end, the little sections bend, the big sections bend, you know, a lot less. So that's what you've got to do if you get your section stuck. Normally, I think a lot of people know now, it is just do it, you know, nice and slowly. Don't rush it and everything will come apart. If it's really bad, take it home, put it on a radiator, if the radiator is hot, and heat it up.
Yeah.
Because that helps massively as well. I've had a couple of sections, not over a lot of, you know, years and years ago. I literally, it's probably before you started doing all this sort of shaking apart the sections, if you like. And I put them on a radiator. I've got it the next morning and they just come apart.
Whoever came up with that three-person system is a bit of a genius.
Absolutely unbelievable. Yeah. Incredible. I've had it with landing net handles as well. Do you know what I mean?
It's fantastic.
I've whacked it on summer and every single time you get three of you on it and everything always comes apart. Just take your time.
Yeah. Tim Ford says he remembers you when you had hair.
Thanks, Tim. Yeah, but what you got to remember, Timmy, you're dealing with different lighting in here. You know what I mean? If I turn this lighting off, mate, I have actually got some. I was going to wear a cap. I thought it was a bit.
Adrian Smith says he's undecided on whether to get the X70 or the X90. I mainly fish commercials with the odd lumps on the pools I fish. I see that Joe, you use a 70. What can you recommend?
Well, obviously,
they're both bloody good, aren't they?
Yeah, I mean, I had the 70 for quite a few months actually as a sample, and obviously I've had my XS90 before that. I never actually had the 90 whilst I had the 70, and I think we all come to the same conclusion: for the cost of that pole to you guys, for what you get, is scary. Yeah, it is unbelievable. Even bearing in mind that.
In the era, Des, of everything in life going up in price, how we've managed to do these poles for the price they are is amazing. It really is.
I mean, if you're not going 6.5 and 16 meters all the time, the 70 will do you proud at everything. You know, river fishing, commercial fishing, big fish, it's done the lot.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, if you're going out sort of surface fishing like I do, you know, in the winter time, you've got to fish 40.5 and 60 meters. That's what you pay your money for, the 90. It's the same with all the top of the range poles. People say, oh, why is that pole another £1,000? Why is it £2,000? You pay your money for those extra two sections, really. Pay your money to have it balanced. Obviously,
X90 is a joke. It's so stiff, isn't it?
It is so quick and so stiff. You know, it all links, not just, you know, 13 and 14.5 and 16. It is actually like a poker, but that's what you pay your money for. You pay that extra money for that 14.5, 16 meters and 17.5 meters if you do that sort of fishing. That's what you're paying for. But seriously, the 70, when we actually seen all the samples, I honestly thought, when I first picked it up, I thought that was the new top of the range pole. Because it was that good, and it wasn't. It was like the 70, not the 90. So personally for me, if you're not going out week in, week out, fishing 16, 14.5 meters, the 70 will do you, well, you'll be amazed when you pick it up. I've actually got one here, because I've got a guy coming around tonight to have a look at it. That's one of the agent's sample poles that he's dropped off, and because he hasn't got time to get to shops, he works shifts. So you come around tonight and pick it up, and it is an absolutely unbelievable pole.
It's a brilliant pole, and I'll tell you what I like about it as well. If you do want to do a bit of F1 fishing, and you do, you know, go to Tunnel Barn and stuff like that, you put the short three and an F1 kit on it, and even at full length, or even with one of the multi extensions on, it's perfectly stiff enough for that game. So
you pay your money for it at the end of the day. That slight, you know, that slight stiffness improvement at long range, and balance. That's what you pay your for. And that comes at a cost, unfortunately. Mm. But that's why the top of the range pole is where it's at. And then literally a grand less is the 70. But that is what you pay your money for. You know, it is that
technology. They're both good, aren't they? Whatever, you know,
I could quite use the 70 for all of my fishing.
Yeah. Well, that's why I went for it, Des, because it's perfect for me, that pole.
I can, because I know someone would say, oh, why are you using that and not your 90? So as a...
You'd be happy with either, though, wouldn't you?
I would be happy with either. Yeah.
Yeah. Just Graham Gamble's tuned in from his sick bed. That's a shame. Yeah. I hope he's all right. All right, Graham. Hope it's not the Omicron. Is it Omicron?
I don't know what it is. I don't want it.
I don't want it.
I've actually got to get me booster jab and that sorted out, hopefully before Christmas.
Yeah, boosted up. Alan says he's just ordered the X50. It'll be his first ever 16-meter pole. Is this a good choice? I'm currently using a MAP 101 3G. Well, it'd be a definite step up from that because that was a cheaper model, wasn't it?
Massive step up. Yeah,
that X50 is brilliant.
It is. We all said it, and we've done lots of talking about it up to now, and the whole range, really. I mean, when we go out to field testing, we literally go out to a lake, we get all the poles that we already produce, we get all the sample poles that we've got, and we get everything. And when we went out field testing, it's like a massive...
Here's a story then, Des. Can you remember when me, you and Robbie went with the first samples of the X10, X20 and X30, and they'd done them on the same mandrel, and people often ask why the mandrels are slightly different, and we got that first lot, and we thought, if we can get this right, we can launch them last August or whatever. Yeah. We got them out, didn't we? And we were like, well, these are nowhere near good enough. And we just sacked the whole thing off, didn't we, and started again.
Yeah.
And people think, oh, it's just the same pole rebadged. And it really isn't. I've even got video footage of us that day.
You can only work on what you've got already and then work on the improvements that you're doing. And when we first had the first batch of samples, it was like, sorry, it ain't good enough.
Mm.
It ain't good enough. So obviously we moved on from there, went out again a couple of times, and it was like, yes. You know, I mean, this is what we're looking for. This is a massive difference. And not just in stiffness, balance, it was the reduced mandrel sizes on the big sections. That to me was the biggest step forward. It was massive to sort of see the mandrel sizes come down, and the poles were a big percentage difference. That to me was a bit mind-boggling.
Yeah,
it's like we have taken a massive step forward now, and obviously there's lots of other things involved in that. It doesn't just end there. You know, you've got all sorts of different things. But that was, you know, when we went out on the last day of doing the samples, we knew that we had something really special.
Hmm.
And obviously, I just, you know, it's easy for me. It's people like Robbie and other people at the factory that have then got to go back and make it all to happen.
Yeah.
But they certainly have. And it's...
It's come out well, hasn't it? It's come out well.
Yeah.
But that honestly, that X50... If you know, because if it's your first ever 16 meter, you might not be fishing it at 16 every week, and it's just a brilliant pole.
It's an all-round pole. I've had a couple of messages already this morning about the X50, and I've used it. We've all used it. We've all had a go on it.
Hmm.
And like I said, you just pay your extra money, really, nowadays. It's all, obviously, if you're buying a more expensive pole, it's better from every section.
Yeah, and you get more performance and more package, don't you?
Yeah, everybody's got a budget. Even I used to, you know, when I started pole fishing, I used to, you know, when a long time ago, I was absolutely gutted because I couldn't afford the most expensive pole. I had a budget. And that's what it comes down to at the end of the day. But the X50, honestly, from what, you know, when we went out to do them samples, it was like the comparison, you know, the level of improvement is massive. So, and you'll love it. And all the top kits, it's just not, as I said to people, it's not just the poles, it's the top kits. We all know these top kits from the first response top kits are ridiculous. Honestly, I'm not just saying that. I have never, ever fished with a pole. I would cry if they change these top kits. I've never had elastic work so well. They're like so stiff, so strong. The length's
perfect, isn't it?
The elastic works so well in them. The length's dead right for all your sort of commercial fishing, everything you do, really. Yeah, I'd be devastated. You wouldn't be able to change them because you wouldn't be able to improve them.
No.
They're what they are.
On the top kits then, obviously, do you want to just run us through what we did with the top kits? Because we really wanted to simplify things. So before we used to have Superpower and Power, we've done away with that. We've just got a carp kit now. And just want to run us through that?
Yeah, we spoke a bit about the match kit anyway, so I'll go through it. Every single top kit now on, which I spoke about already, well, not today, but in previous videos, every single section is marked. So you've got
depth markers,
inches, 12 inches, 18 inches, all the way up to, I think it's like 4 foot.
60 inches, isn't it?
Yeah, 60 inches, which is really nice. Because even if you're catching shallow, if you're catching down the edge, if you've been anywhere and I've had a port in a certain depth, you can come off of there, it's on the pole, you know, and you don't have to think about it next time you go to a certain venue, or maybe a week later, you think, well, I'll just plumb up it 3 foot and just put your foot float to 3 foot and you're done. Every single section now is marked. So that's the match on there. It's all done in silver for you, nice and simple. Because it's not so much the match kits. I think the match kits were pretty sort of self-explanatory, really, what they were. But it's the other top kits where people got a little bit confused. And I used to as well. And I said, look, we need to make sure that the top kits are all marked up. The next one up from the match kit is the F1 top two.
Yeah.
That's what that one says
on there. I think it's worth going into this a bit because a lot of people hear F1 kit and they just assume one piece F1 kit now. But we've always done a two piece F1 as well as a one piece, haven't we?
Yeah, basically an F1 top two. It's called an F1, but it's an F1 basically same length, or all the same lengths, but there's the match kit and the power kit. So they're all 2.4s, all perfectly, you know, lined up ready. But this is basically a match top, slightly beefed up and only very slightly, because the match tops are ridiculously strong anyway. But it's basically got a bigger bore size in it. So the number one section, which is that, the thinner one of the two, obviously, we've put in a bigger bore for it. We could probably fit in there. I don't really run much more than a 13 through them. It's not because of the strength. It's because of what I'm actually doing with that top kit. So that will take a 13 Dura slip, a 12 hollow, something like that. So that's what it's about. People, when they're F1, there's a lot, you know, a lot of us go F1 fishing now. You could quite easily use them top kits for silverfish fishing as well. But obviously the bore size, when I'm surface fishing, like a match kit, I like that sort of flick, like that sort of flick tip, if you like, when you're striking out with light lines.
A little bit of action.
Yeah, small hooks, where that obviously is proper stiff. It's perfect for F1s and carp. I could use that for carp fishing and F1s and silvers. But it's basically the same quality as in lightness of a match kit. It's just got the number one section there. It's just a lot, basically. It's not as fast tapered. So it comes to the end where we can put a bigger bore size in it. So that's what the F1 two or two piece section's all about. Loads and loads of people love them.
Like a crossover kit then, isn't it?
Yeah. It's very similar to a match kit, apart from it's basically got a bigger bore size. And and all the sections this year on the new Superium poles, we've actually made the bores a little bit bigger in each one.
The bush end, you mean?
The bush end. So that's the match, the F1, and the carp top, we've made them slightly bigger so you can run bigger elastics through, because that's what people want. That's what our anglers want. Obviously, we spoke about it and said, well, we'll just reduce, you know, make the sections a little bit not as fast tapered so we can put a bigger internal bush in. Mm-hmm. Then moving on to the carp. Obviously, it's carp on there rather than F1. Match kit tells you exactly what it is. I've got that 13 Dura in there, but you can run whatever you want. I've got sections with 17 Dura in, and I could put 19 in. And again, all marked up with the depth markers. And again, bigger bore. There's actually a bigger bore in there than the previous carp tops we've done. So you can actually get a 19 Dura through that.
So all the top kits, just to break off, they're all pre-bushed, aren't they? And they've all got roller pullers in, except the match kit.
Except the match kit. So,
The roller pullers are 10 each. You get your bush. So that's an extra 12 quid worth of stuff as well.
Exactly. And there's 65 quid.
And an aligner in the number two.
Yeah, aligner in there. Look, so they've been in there from day one. So you get your elastic aligner in there, which are absolutely superb. Protects your elastic as well when you're packing it away. And they're 65 quid. Mm. It's scary, really. So that's your kit. It's really nice and simple. Cupping kit as well.
We do F1 one-piece kits, Des, don't we? Just before we...
Yeah. Yeah, F1 one-piece kits, obviously, if you want them, you can buy them separately. They've got the same, they're Ghost as well. You can have Ghost, I think you can have just a normal black carbon as well, I think.
You can have black or white, yeah.
Or white, they're all, obviously exactly the same. They've all got the side pullers in, pre-bushed, bigger bores again, because that's what people want. Yeah, basically ready to go.
Yeah.
But then the cupping kit, I get asked a lot about cupping kits, or I have done in the previous as well for many years. That's obviously just got the cupping kit on it, Now, that is what that is like a telescopic. That's what comes with it. They're brilliant. Now, when you get your pole, you get an actual cupping kit in a plastic balloon packaging, if you like. Now, it's got two of those adapters on it. So that's the adapter with the little brass thread. Now, you, inside, I'm not sure I've got the small one here somewhere. But anyway, basically, when you look at the end of that bush, it's you get two different sizes. You get a smaller one internal and you get a fatter one. You need the fatter one. And it's really, but make sure you don't let this section go out through the end. Make sure you've got this section out before you put that adapter on. Because I know it's really difficult. If you take that number one out and then put it on, it's really difficult to get it back up through. So make sure when you get your cupping kit, you pull that out like that and then put your adapter on. Now, to make this identical length to your, because what basically I do when I get to my peg now, I pull that out until it stops. So it won't turn because it's out enough to stop it from turning. And that is exactly the same length as all my tops. So it's 2.4. And the way to do that is use the bigger one of the two, because obviously the smaller one's got a different bore size in it. That's the fatter one of the two. And you literally cut with an axle about an inch off of the cupping kit. So you take an inch off, put the bigger adapter in of the two, super glue it. You can probably see on that. All I do is put it on and I put a blob of super glue around there and that's it. And you pull it out to its maximum like that. And that's exactly the same as your top kits. There's no messing. There's no thinking involved. And that's what you want from a cupping kit. You just want to take it out, stop it. And I know now when I put that on there, when you put your cup on, basically your elastic is in the middle of the big pot. You can't get any easier. So cut about that much off, put the bigger adapter on. You can put the small adapter on, but I work when I want some at the same length, I want some at the same length. I don't want to be thinking it's that much further and that much closer. So if you put the bigger adapter on, cut your carbon off that much with a little junior axle, nice fine blade, put it on, super glue around the top, leave it overnight, and it's perfect. It's absolutely, you know, bang on. You'll be fishing with it the next day.
Just got to mention something, by the way.
Yeah.
This is slightly off topic. Obviously, we gave away the Absolute Seat Box last week.
Yeah.
The 50,000 subscribers. Thanks everyone who took the time to subscribe. We're going to do another comp very, very soon. Now, a lot of people were unhappy. They said it was a fix and it was no one's going to receive it, right?
If I had to actually do a video, if such, on somebody it was going to be fixed, I would refuse to do it.
The funny thing is, we've had to send that box to Germany because Stephen, who won it, is in Germany.
Right.
It cost us £350 to get it there.
Jesus, wow.
So if anyone believes it's fixed, my ass was on the chopping block last week because I picked someone in Germany to win. So I just wanted to put that out there.
It's not fixed. It's not fixed. It's
definitely not fixed.
I wouldn't do it. I would honestly refuse to do anything like that if it was fixed.
Yeah.
You know, I'd
get that out there because a few people were moaning that they probably don't ever give these prizes away or that. But trust me, having about to price up the carriage cost for that.
Stephen's out there. Take a selfie of it with yourself and send us it in.
He's gone low, Stephen is, when he as soon as he gets it. He should get it this back end of this week, which is nice, hopefully. Right, which pole would you say is a top all-rounder?
Well, it depends on your budget, but the pole for me, if you're a river angler, you know, canal angler, commercial angler, for me, it's a 70. If you can push your budget and you're fishing, you know, quite long distances to islands, then try and push it. I had the guy on this morning. And I said, look, if you are that sort of angler where you fish tight up to islands with 40 and a half, 16 meters, try and push yourself to the 70. Mm-hmm. You know, I know a lot of you don't do that sort of fishing, but if you do and you can just push your budget a bit, try and get to the 70 if you can. I'm not saying, you know, the 50, the cart pole. It's just, I know from, you know, from having my pole, if you fish like that a lot of your weekend and you're a really competitive match angler, which I know you all, you know, a lot of you are, then try and push your budget to a pot. I always say that. But if you can't, you can't. But it's just that 14 half and 16 where you will see, you know, and it'll make a big benefit to your fishing. You know, when you're striking, we've done videos on it, you know, and I was at IVA a couple of weeks ago, I mean 90, it was flat calm, fishing nice short lines, trying to catch these little stocky carp that have been caught a lot now. You know, they're real cute and the bites are like a tremble. And I was fishing my pole, it's a true 16, so I got the 16 meter piece and the dolly butt on. And it was just like, that's what you pay your money for. That is what, you know, that's why I use that pole, you know. But I know if I was using the 70 or a 50, I would know it would do the job. It just wouldn't do it like the 90 does. Mm. And like I said, I keep going back because it's the truth. That's what you pay
your money for.
That's what you pay your money for at the end of the day. You know, they're all the same mandrel, the carp, the 50, the 70, and the 90 are all the same mandrels. But you pay, you know, obviously a carp pole is different. Carp poles, it's a full-blown carp pole. We have to change things on that pole to suit what you guys want to do with it, you know. So, but the 50, the 70, and the 90, they're all the same mandrel. It's just that it's actually, people say, oh, it's not a lot of difference, but it is a lot of difference to make a pole 14 half 16 to do what it does. There's a lot of technology on it, you know, a lot of technology on it. So that carbon's obviously more expensive, it's more crisper, and basically, yeah. So,
well, moving on to the carp pole, because someone, Holly H. Jev is asking, or Ian Jevons, I had the Response M70, served me very well, and I want to upgrade to the new Superium poles. Now, I mainly fish commercials with big carp and F1s in. Would you recommend the carp or the 70? Now, it's worth saying that Ian will be able to use his top kits and number three sections off his Response. I think it might even go down to the four.
Six, is it?
Yeah, so he's going to have a bit of crossover there as well, which is nice.
So if you're a river angler and you don't want to, if you're worried about your number fours, fives, you know, because it's top five deep, they'll all fit. It's down to your six section. I think your six is a 10 meter piece. But yeah, if you've got a 70, what's his name again, Joe?
Ian, he had an M70 before, and he wants to know whether he should use an X carp or an X70.
If you've got a 70 from an X from a carp pole, there's a lot of difference in that, because like going back to a full blown carp pole, it has to flex a little bit more than what your X70 or your XS70 would have. I think personally for me, if you had a 70, you would want the new 70. Personally, I think if you went to a carp pole from having that, you
might feel a bit heavy, mightn't it?
Yeah, it might feel a bit sort of, you know, not as nice to fish with it long distance. It depends on what distances you're fishing. But I think for you personally, I think if I was in a shop and you said to me, I've got an XS70, I'm looking to go carp or 70, I'd say, well, get that out, have a wagon of it. And I know from like what we've done on the bank, the 70 can handle anything. You know, I've been on the rivers with it, and it is just a complete all-rounder. It's like the 50 and the carp. They're all-rounders, but it is going back. I say, if you guess going full-blown carp fishing, and then the carp pole, we sold lots and lots of Response carps because then people want that. They want that. But I think if you've had a 70 or an XS70, I think you'd have to, you'd have to go and get the X70 personally. That would be my opinion anyway.
Graham Wells. Hi guys, long time listener, first time caller. Started out last year and bought an X200, a prototype. Looking to upgrade to a 16 meter model, would you suggest the X50?
Yes, yeah. 100%.
Nice step that.
Brilliant step, absolutely perfect. Or the carp pole.
Hmm.
That, you know, depends on what you do, Graham. If you go carp fishing a lot, I think the carp pole or the X50 would do you. It just depends on what top kits you want. Obviously, the carp pole comes with all top kit, all power tops, where the X50, I think, comes with two top match tops.
Yeah, I believe.
I've said it 3,000 times, but I can't quite remember.
Comes with a match top in the pole, a match kit spare, two F1 kits, four carp kits, cupping kit, and a hole door.
You get a little bit more sort of freedom, if you like, with the top kits. If you do a bit of surface fishing and you do a lot of commercial fishing, you want a bit of river fishing and all that, then the X50 will sort of fit into your around you. Where if you're just a full blown commercial angler, then I think your carp hole, that would be the two I would be aiming for, the X50 or the carp. But I think that, you know, I think either would do you proud. It just depends on where you're going, what you're catching. And maybe if you want a bit of flexibility in top kits, then the X50 would probably push it for me towards, you know.
I'll say, look, they're the hold holes, by the way, that you get with these poles. And it's a proper, the same as the Superior one, just to say how good they are. So you're not just getting a cheap, nasty hold hole as well with your pole.
That's the whole range, apart from the margin pole.
Margin, yeah, even like the X10 comes with the same hold hole tubes and that. So yeah. You are getting a proper package.
Your day-to-day fishing.
Yeah.
But that's what I'd say, Graham. If you're 50, if you've got a bit of flexibility with your top kits of 50, if you're an out-and-out blown full commercial angler, I think your carp top might sort of, you know,
your carp pole
would probably be the one.
Yeah. Darren Steggles wants to know, what makes these new poles better than the Response XS range?
Well, Darren, it's hard to say because obviously you've got improvements of carbon, you've got improvements of, and I keep going back to reduced mandrels. That is the big thing for me, to make a pole with, you know, reduced section sizes and make them better. And when I say better, I mean it is a big improvement. That's what we've done. They're just better all round. They're better balanced, they're stiffer, and that's what the improvements are. But with the reduced bore size, I've taken, you know, people have come up to me and they've obviously had a go on my pole and I said, well, look, your 13-metre piece, your 60-metre piece now is like the 13-metre pieces from the XS's. And they're like, Christ almighty, yeah, that's really small.
Mm.
So that's the big improvements. And that's what you do. Everything moves on. And that's what we've done with these poles. That's the improvements. That's why we've changed from what we had previously to what we've got now. You have to move on. And it doesn't get easy to improve on poles nowadays. I've got the recycling lots, lads, and they're really noisy. I wouldn't want to be working night shift at the moment. I'd be out the window. Oi! You know what I mean? So to come up with improvements is very, very difficult. Very difficult. And we've done that massively with this range of poles.
Yeah. And like Joe, it's nice having all the poles across the range having the same top kits and that, isn't it?
Exactly. And like Joe said, when we looked at all these poles, when we went out field testing the poles, and I'm thinking, this is all well and good, Robbie, but how much are they going to cost? And he's like, well, that is actually 150 quid cheaper than last year's model. And I'm like, you what? And that's 100 quid cheaper than last year's model. And the 90 is the same price as last year's model. I'm like, well, I don't know how you've done it, but fair play. And that helps the cause, whichever way you look at it.
Yeah, of course it does.
So, yeah.
Hey, someone's coming to get you.
That. Yeah, but that could be one or the other. That could be an ambulance or a police car. So I hope it's a police car and not an ambulance.
Can you use the F1 kits okay on the carp pole? And what's it like at 60 metres? I can't test one anywhere at the moment.
Yeah, you can fit them straight on. Like Joe just said, all the top kits fit the whole range now. So obviously, if you already own an XS response, the top kits all interchange.
Hmm.
They're just a bit of improvement on the top kits. Obviously, you've got your depth markers. And we've obviously put the bigger bore sizes in to take bigger elastics. But everything fits, you know, your top threes. But obviously, this is your carp, your 50, 70, and 90. They all interchange everything. Yeah. And then the top six from your XS's will fit. And I said, if you want to put a short number three in a carp pole with a short F1 kit, that will make it like a poker.
Oh, yeah, what was that?
I don't know. Probably a bottle. He's probably hit someone over the head with a bottle.
Hey, someone's had a good night by the sounds of that.
Oh yeah, they do get on it around here, I'll tell you.
What is it, old Thatcher's?
Yeah, you can hear him like every night, bosh, bosh, bosh in the recycling bins. Not mine, by the way. T-total. But yeah, if you put a short number three on a cart pole with a short F1 kit, it would be like a poker.
Yeah. But you did. Me and Lee did some filming with the cart pole using the short kit, and it was brilliant. Brilliant. Yeah. So.
But look, you know, go and get in the shop, try and get someone who's got one and have a lip. Everybody will be mega impressed. Everybody's picked my pole up, and some of them have already got a 90, an XS 90. They're like, that is so much better. And when people are telling you that, you know that you've done it.
I think we've hit the nail on the head with them, haven't we?
When they're like, oh, actually, not, I can't really tell the difference there. But when everybody who's got on it said, bloody hell.
Well, I mean, obviously, like the X90, I know it's $2,999, which is a staggering amount of money. But nowadays, flagship poles are $4,000 and $5,000, aren't they?
I honestly thought the new XS90, what was that? I just seen someone walk past your window.
I was just thinking that myself.
Halloween. I thought someone was going to like do a Halloween thing on the
Hopefully
window.
It's someone to come and hoover up all the blue bottles out and
right.
a bit of a hatch.
And like you said, some of the poles out there are $4,000. And when we got these poles, I honestly thought there was going to be like another £800 on top of that. And there isn't. And what can you say? I was really happy about that because I know it helps us do what we need to do.
I've actually just asked, how do you ever compare them to the competition? Obviously we do. And we've got good relationships with some tackle shops with pole alleys and stuff. And we take them along and compare them and just how it works.
But price is, we all know price is mega, mega important. And it's not just the price of the poles. It's the price of your spares.
Yeah.
If I owned a £5,000 pole and I had to buy a number 10, 11 meter piece, I wouldn't even want to think what them sections would cost. Oh. It must be colossal. And, you know, yeah, that's how it is. If you buy an expensive car, a really expensive car, and you wallop it, it's going to cost you a lot more money to repair a Fiat Corsa, a Fiat Punto or something. But we have taken that in consideration. You know, we've pushed the boundaries a long way. There's no cost involved. And that, to me, with the package that they brought out, or Preston that brought out, is mega, as far as I was concerned. And it makes our life a lot, lot easier, because trying to say to you, well, this pole's gone up another £1,500 and them small improvements, people are going to say, well, yeah, all right, that's never £1,500. But then you've got all your spares involved in that. If you break it, someone clobbers it. God,
just top kits, Des. I dare say our top kits are half the price of our competitors.
I've said this story plenty of times. I remember it at the Farnborough show when Robbie, who's our product guy at Preston, and Scott Jeans used to work for Preston. And I was on, this is when we launched the response polls. And I got to find out about the top kits. And I'm like, because I'm going to get asked, how much are they? And they said, they're £45. I said, no. I said, I need the RRP price. So that's what you guys would pay. And they're like, yeah, £45. I'm like, well, how is that possible? How can you produce a top kit of that quality for £45? But how many years have the response been out?
God, a while now.
I think it's 5 years.
More than that.
Is it?
Well, yeah, I've been pressing 3 years now.
Yeah, so say 5 years, for example, they've gone up £15 in 5 years minimum, which is...
I reckon it's 7-8 years now.
Yeah, which is ridiculous. You know, it's mega, really, because it's gone up £15 in 6-7 years. Yeah. And what you get quality-wise, unbeatable.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Right,
Agent... I forgot completely what the question was.
Gone off tangent, didn't we? At the moment, I fish with a cart pole, which is strong but heavy. It's not a Preston carp, he says. I'm looking to upgrade my choice, and I'm looking at either a Superium X50 or a Superium X carp. Would I be better sticking to a cart pole, having used a cart pole in the past?
Well, this is totally the opposite to what Graham's question was. He's already got a 70, and he's asking the question, do I go to a cart pole or a 70? Now, I said to him, I'd probably stick with the 70 because of what he's got. Now, if you've got a cart pole, I don't know what cart pole you've got. I would say the cart pole would be the one for you. You're used to a cart pole. You obviously do that sort of fishing. So what you're saying to me is, what's his name, Joe?
Adrian.
Adrian, if I was you, I'd go to the Superium carp, personally. You can have the 88 top kits, which are going to take all your thick elastics. You know what I mean? If you're bagging up down the edge and you just want a bit of flexibility with it, then I think the carp pole would do you proud.
Yeah.
And it is a mega pole. I mean, just the improvement, the XS carp was good, but the improvement on that is big. It's big. It really is big.
Yeah, it's big. It's big.
So I would say have a look at the Superium X Carp. And I think you'll have to somehow get your missus to sign the check.
I saw on the comments on Facebook the other day that someone's wife says, "I've just bought him a surprise X70. I was like, that's unbelievable.
Your number, then. What's that? I'd have to go and work about 17 weeks overtime to get him. And even then, that was like trying to get blood out of a stone.
Cameron Stewart says he's got the Edge Monster. Is the Superior margin better or about the same?
He's got, what was that? What was
Edge
the word?
Monster. He's got the 8-meter.
Yeah,
Edge Monster.
Oh, massive difference,
yeah,
Cameron.
It's a totally different.
Oh, difference, but completely different. That is like chalk and cheese.
Mm-hmm.
That the new margin, the Superior margin.
So light, isn't it?
It's so light and so stiff. It is like a poker. It really is. You could use that if you were like fishing to hand for a big roach in Ireland and things like that. I know you're not, but obviously going to be doing that. But that's the sort of how quality that pole, that little margin pole is. Yeah,
also the top kits interchange with the rest of the range.
Yeah, it's a big step up. That a big, big step.
Yeah.
You know, and then obviously a lot of you guys might like, you know, love the margin pole, and they might want to buy an X20 because they want like a 30-meter pole. If you just want a real quality margin pole, then yeah, Cameron, to be honest, your eyes are popping. If you took your margin pole in a shop that had one of the new ones and put them up together, you'd be like,
But that's why that one is, I think it's like 400 quid, isn't it?
And yeah, exactly.
Monster is 150 quid, isn't it?
Exactly. So. There's a big difference in price.
Yeah, 350 quid, that is. So
your margin poles, your monster margin is 150.
Yeah.
So there's a big price difference there as well. But you'll see the difference.
It's all relative, isn't it?
You'll see where the money's gone when you pick it up.
Yeah. Kev says he currently uses a Response M50. It's been a brilliant pole once I got used to it, as he broke a couple of sections for his own use early on. If I got the new X50, would I be able to use my 2.4-meter and 1.85-meter Response top kit?
Yes, straight on.
Yeah.
Down to your top six. So that would be, I think it's 10 meters or top six, I think. Fine. It's either the 10 meter piece or the 9 meter piece. But yeah, everything fits apart from, I think it's 11, 13, and 60 doesn't fit. Everything else above that, up to your top kit, all fit from your excesses to the new Superiums. Mm-hmm. So there's no problem with anything. All your top kits, your cupping kits, your F1 short stops, all that will go straight on the new Superiums.
Bream for Life, do you compare your poles to other pole makers? I've got a Tubertini, but looking for a change. I don't think it's fair for us to say, like, oh, that's a rubbish pole or a great pole. It's not really our place to say that. It's up to you guys to make that choice.
People say to me, oh, have you picked this up? I said, to be honest, I'm not interested.
No, it's not.
We work as a company to what we do, yeah. And that's...
It's not fair game if we start slagging other people's kit off. It's not fair.
You need to go into the shops and pick them up and make your own decision on that. And that comes down to several things, price, you know, all sorts of different things.
Like I said earlier, when we're developing them and designing them and stuff, we do take them to shops and compare them to the other models, but that's for our knowledge. It's not for us to come out and say XYZ pole's rubbish or whatever. That's not cricket, in my opinion.
I can't really remember the time that I've actually got on the bank and add my pole that, and I said to someone, I'll bring that up, let's have a look at that. I can't really, it just doesn't interest me now. That seems to have all gone by the side.
Poles are great, aren't they?
Yeah, and we don't need to do that anymore. we've come on so big and so well with poles, we don't need to get other manufacturers' poles in and put them up to ours. We work, you know, we work to what we do, and that's it. That's the truth of the matter. It's not as if you go to the factory and Robbie, our product guy, has got like 10 different companies' poles and say, oh, well, this is this and that. We don't need to do that. It's pointless.
Oh, yeah, just for any football fans out there. Steve Ring has just texted me saying Man United have had a redraw in the Champions League. So that's great.
That sounds like his sort of thing. It happened in the
yeah, redraw.
When he's not drawn very well.
Sorry, comments just caught my eyes. It's all well and good promoting this, but any signs of them being available? They're in tackle shops now.
There's been a big, because I've had a few phone calls, you know, people pretty peeved off, and I totally get it. But I did speak to one of the guys who I deal with at Preston, and I said, look, I've had a few phone calls this morning. They're really peeved off. They said, Des, we can't send. I can't remember any polls they've sent. A lot.
We've got more coming this week. So
the thing, what's happened is the courier cannot physically take that many polls out because they've all come in. You know, the guys in the warehouse are probably pouring out. If Dave Lloyd's listening, we're sorry, Dave, but
he's too busy calming down from his dancing on Friday night.
Too busy from his cider giveaway party that he had. But yeah, obviously I didn't realise until I made the phone call that they obviously if 800 polls are going out, they can't send 800 polls out in a day. It's just impossible. So obviously they have gone out so many per day and they're still going out. So some of you people that have ordered them and not got them, they are in the factory. They're just trying to feed them out slowly but surely.
Yes, they're coming in all the time as well, so it's not going to
be issue. Yeah, there's spares coming in, all the top kits. Is for what the amount of money involved in this is, I wouldn't mind it in my bank account, I'll tell you. I wouldn't be Zoom meeting here in my garage. I'd be Zoom meeting in probably
the helicopter pad.
Florida, from Marlin somewhere.
Yeah. Jeff Ball says, the short number three section, is this for all the poles or is it for a specific poles? It fits them all.
Fits them all, Jeff. Straight on. Everything. So don't...
Ian Owen says he's not seen the poles anywhere.
That's actually wrong because it will... What you got to remember is the mandrels on the carp, the 50, the 70, the 90 will all fit.
No, the short three fits all the poles.
Oh, sorry. The short three.
Three fits all the poles.
Using myself.
Ian says he's not seen them anywhere. I've seen them in loads of shops.
Yeah.
On Facebook and that. I can't. Every time I look at Facebook, I see a Superium.
I always say to people in my area, look, try and support your local shops. I know there's lots of people that are like, oh, I'll just buy it, you know. But seriously, without your local shops, and I always say that, it's like my local shops. I always support them because without them, where am I going to buy my part of my, you know, where am I going to go buy my bait? Where am I going to buy my ground bait and bits and pieces like that? So try and give your local shops, even though they might take a little bit more time to get them in, give them a chance because it's really important for all of us. Mm-hmm. It really is. I will say.
Mark wants to know how many number three sections you get with the X70. You only get the one in the pole on this occasion. Robert Driscoll says, can I give a shout out for the drop bucket, the Superior drop bucket? It's a godsend for someone who's not very good on their legs.
Yeah.
Sorry, it keeps jumping.
I should take that bucket with me every time I go fishing, but I keep forgetting. I use it on the Stour and stuff because without that, I'd be in Ned first, which is all right on a summer's day. It ain't good in the winter. But I should take it with me every day, really.
When will you be doing a video with the X50 in action? Zolt has actually done several videos that will be coming out over the next few weeks with anglers using the X50, so you'll get a chance to see that. Will these top kits fit onto my Edge Monster?
No. No, they won't. That is the Edge Monster top kit.
Prototype mandrel.
For the prototype mandrel. So the old prototype poles, they're all the same top kits. So they won't fit the new Superiums, none of them, unfortunately. That was a nice guy. I like them questions.
Do they fit the response margin pole?
Yes. Anything with response, excess with poles, any of them, they all interchange with the new Superiums. So everything, top kit. I'm not sure about how many joints, but it's definitely the number one, the top kit and the number three section will all fit.
You always get someone's, obviously we're catching up with the questions a bit now.
Yeah.
Some people's asking about how do you clip up. I don't think this is the video for that. Blah, 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 blah. Why don't Preston make a true 16-meter pole without the dolly button? I'll let you answer that one, Dave.
Well, there's several companies that have tried, and mathematics, well, I don't know exactly what goes on, but all I know is I've obviously fished in Europe quite a bit. And to make a pole 13 meters and 16 meters doesn't work out. The joints are in the wrong place. It affects the pole massively. And that's basically what it is. That is the fact that the joints are in certain areas because you get the best out of what you've got. And trying to make a pole which is 13 and 16, it don't work out. It's where the joints are. It's very, like, very technical. And I've tried to find out. And when you start speaking to people about it, you just thought, I wish I never asked that question. Because it is very, very technical. Where the joints are, you know, in an area of a pole. Even most 13-meter poles in Europe, you would still have to put a dolly butt up it to make it 13 meters. Because it just doesn't work out. You can't get the best out of the carbon unless you do it a certain way. That is basically the facts of it. That's it, really. Yeah. It's about the joint. It's about where the joints are.
Mm-hmm.
I've said it in some of the videos, previous videos a few years ago. If you've got the old excess pole and you put the little mini joint up it, it can actually make it feel better because it makes it stiffer because of that little joint.
Mm.
And you wouldn't believe it, even though you're making something slightly longer, it, because of that stiffness in that joint, it affects the rest of the pole. Very technical.
Very technical.
It is very technical.
Oh. I'm getting loads of messages about the Champions League redraw.
Why are they?
Oh, it's just corruption, isn't it? They've just missed. I don't really know. I just want to say it's not corruption. The opinions are mine, they're not Press Innovations.
That was like down to the point there, Joe.
Blah, 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 blah. Good afternoon, Joe and Des. Good afternoon, Adrian. Right, I got a GXR 3600 and an Edge Monster. I find myself using the Edge Monster more as I'm more confident in it. If I was to upgrade, what would give me the hybrid between the two?
So he's got a 3600.
Hmm.
Probably the cart pole, if you can push it to that, but because that 3600 was quite, that was 1500 quid when it came out, I think. What I can remember about that. So yeah, the cart pole's actually cheaper than that. So I would, if you want something like smack in the middle of that, then I would say the Superium carp. You could come down to the X40. But personally, if you've got a 3600, like I said to Graham and the other guy earlier, I think I'm just looking at what you already got and what you fish with. I think the carp pole would be bang on for you, personally, because you're doing a lot of carp fishing. That's why you like your margin pole. So if you wanted to sort of get rid of both of them and just have one pole that does everything, I would say the carp pole.
This is actually a really good question from Thomas. Is the X10, 20 and 30 the new prototype range?
Basically, they've taken over.
Yeah. Basically. It was a bit awkward before because our top kits were different, weren't they? The prototype top kits were really fat. The response ones were skinny. So we wanted to make it easier across the board, didn't we?
Makes it easier for everybody. You know, when people say, oh, like the questions we're getting now about top kits, it just completely diminishes that. It finishes it. It finishes that sort of, oh, what top kit do I need for this, top kit for that? You don't. Everything now, all interchanges. So no matter if you've got the 10 to the 90, it all fits on the top kit side of it. So you ain't got to worry about that now.
Yeah.
Basically, if you want a spare, you go into a shop and say, I want a Superium top kit, and you know they'll all fit. Doesn't matter what pole you've got. So it makes it, just stops the confusion completely. And obviously, the poles are a lot, lot better anyway. So from the pro types.
Oh, it's a night and day difference.
Yeah. Chalk and cheese again.
Yeah.
Huge difference.
Yeah. Ash has bought the X50. Nice one, Ash. Should he get the margin poll to complement it? That's personal choice, really, isn't it?
Personal choice, Ash. Yeah, I mean, if you go somewhere and you're absolutely empty in the joint, a few snags around, and you really want something that is, you know, get into it, that it's like my brother. My brother, he's a classic example. He's got a carp pole, but he just loves fishing with his little margin pole. And I'm like, what's the matter? You know, why? He said, Jez, I just love it. He said, just I'm only fishing short. You know, you can chuck it around, you know, and that it is as simple as that, really. He's got a, I think he's got a monster margin. He might have one of the response ones, actually, the older ones.
Mm.
And he just chucks it around. You know, he's, that's what it's like. And I think that's what some people want. But it is, like Joe said, it's personal choice in that. So, yeah, I would say, you know, if you really want something, you can chuck about a bit more and be a bit, you know, don't chuck it in the mud and chuck it on the stones, and then get, you know, go for the sort of margin pole as well. Because you've got to respect whatever pole you've got to respect it. You know, you've got to look after it a little bit, you know, clean it up, make sure there's no grit and that on it, because it, you know, at the end of the day, it's an expensive piece of kit and it's carbon. So you've got to respect whatever pole you've got. Doesn't matter if it's a 400 quid pole or a 3 grand pole.
Les Moody says he's checked the poles out. He says the 70 is an outstanding bit of kit. It really is.
Yeah, it is, Les. It is. It's very, I mean, like I said, it is. It, there's always something in poles. When you see a new load of poles and you pick one up, and like going back to what we've already spoke about, when you look at the, because obviously price comes into it and it comes out, you know, what you're getting for your money. And that pole for me was, you know, very, very hard to sort of, how the hell have you done it? Because I honestly thought that was going to be a 2,400 quid pole.
Yeah.
Isn't, it's nowhere near it.
Yeah. Robin, hi chaps. I currently run a excess carp, which has been great for Todber. What would you recommend, a 70 or a 90 for more F1 focused venues like Ivy House, Heron Lake?
70, Robin, 100%, mate. Honestly, I mean, my brother, I think my brother's probably due a new pole now, and I, a 70 for him would be absolutely perfect. He's doing the same sort of fishing as what you are. So I would say a 70, 100%.
Mm-hmm.
Bang on.
Dennis wants to know, how come Preston's don't do starter kits in all modes of fishing for beginner anglers? We used to do the Corman ones years ago, didn't we?
Yeah, it's a difficult one because you think the problem is with it as well. You know, I go into some shops, and they've all got, maybe not starter kits, but they've got like a rod reel bundle, or, you know, not so, maybe so much poles.
We just started doing that phase one stuff through Corum, haven't we? Which is really cheap rods and reels.
Yeah,
and they've sold really well.
Yeah, and that's what I think now. Instead of having a package of saying plop, here we go. The shops have got the budget stuff in, if you like, for starters. And then people just say, as long as the shops have got time to actually give the people some time, you know, maybe set some up for them. I think that's more important than having a starter kit.
Yeah.
I know some shops, you know, I think that's really important, you know.
Well, the phase one stuff from Corum, I think you get a rod and a reel for 50 quid, RRP. So I think that's a really good price, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. And I think, like I said, time in shops spent with someone who's going to give you a bit of time for your starter, that means everything. You know, I know it takes a bit of time, but I think that's more important than just giving them a package and say, "You right, get on with it." You know.
It's Thomas says, is the X50 and X-Carp the same pole?
No.
No, not even close.
No, same mandrel. They're all the same mandrel. The 90 down to the cart, but they are not the same pole. Absolutely nowhere near it.
Yeah. This is quite an interesting question, Des. We'll come back to that one because Thomas has put in quite a lot of questions. I'm disabled with a broken back and fish commercials a lot with mixed fish, roach, tench, carp, etc. Which pole would you recommend weight-wise?
Well, if you're not fishing out very far, then you could probably go for a 20 or a 30. Even personally, it just depends on the distance. I don't think, obviously I don't really know, but if you're fishing somewhere like 8 to 10 meters, maybe even a bit further, or if you want the option of maybe going to 11 or 13, I think the 30 would do you. personally, I think, you know, it is down to like your budget. And like, obviously them sort of not so expensive poles, they are stronger than the more expensive poles. It's not, you know, let's not beat about the bush there. That is the truth. It's like a full blown cart pole is stronger than some of the other poles because it is made to do that specific job. So I think if you're, you know, what you're telling me, I mean, if you looked at the 20 or the 30, you know, which ain't going to break the bank, I think that would probably be a real good choice for you.
Mm.
Simply that, or even the margin. If you want 10 meters, if you don't go more than 10 meters.
I say that's not a bad shout, the margin.
The margin would do you because it's stiff. It's so stiff and so easy to use. And obviously it's a margin pole, so it's going to be mega, mega strong. So if you're not going past 10 meters, have a look at the margin. If you think you're going to push yourself and go 11 and a half, maybe 13, then have a look at the X20 or the X30.
Yeah.
Because you obviously get a bit more spares in them poles as well. So if you need a few more spares, but like I said, going back to spares again, you're not breaking the bank by buying a spare. They're 60 odd quid.
Mm.
So whatever spare you want, it's 60 odd quid. So you can work it out, you know, would it be better for me to buy a 20 or a 30 with a few more spares, or should I stick with the margin and buy a couple of spares? That's your sort of, you know, that's the decision you've got to make.
Yeah. Craig says he bought a 10 meter edge monster last year. And it's the first pole he's bought in years, and he was in total shock at the price and quality. And he says, and that's your cheap pole. So obviously he's saying that the pole's amazing for the money, which they are because they come pre-bushed and everything.
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, crazy. I've used them, and you just think, well, I could, you know, if I was fishing short a lot of the time on bagging up venues, I could use that. No problem. It's just that it's just like going back to what I've said earlier. It's going back to that balanced, how stiff, how rigid it is, how quick it is. It's striking. That's what you know, that's where you pay your money. And obviously length comes into it, 16 meters and, you know, That's why we do different packages, you know, 13 meters, 14, even in the X10. Is it the X10 or 20?
What's that?
The 10, isn't it? The X10.
13 meter package.
13, then it goes to 14 and a half, and then 16. So you've got that option, and that's why it's different price brackets.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, the monster, that little monster edge, when you first got it for the cost of it, you're like, that's why you sold thousands of them, basically.
Yeah, it's probably the most popular pole on the market, I would say. Right, Craig says, do you do a full product range magazine and where can I grab one? We do a consumer guide and it should be in your tackle shop. If not, ask them to get you one because the agents have got them in their cars, so they'll be able to get you one. When are the new floats come in? Should they be this week or next? So hopefully it'll be this week.
New floats. I've got a few in there. That's actually how I got them delivered on the bank when I was doing a shoot about them. I'm like, well, yeah. I haven't got that many, actually. That looks a lot, but I've not got many. I've tied a few up.
They're good, though, aren't they?
They are very, very good. Yeah, they are awesome.
Yeah, really nice. Yeah. Would you use the F1 top kit as a match kit? And what was the pole bag look like for the Superium race? The pole bag's just behind me there. It's the same as the Superior. I think it's an 8-10 tube pole doll. So it's got that zip around the top. There's a full length zip down the side. You can get loads of kit in that bag.
What was the other question? Would I use a...
would you use an F1 top kit as a match kit?
Yes. I actually use them. I've got some in my things there. They're old ones. I've not got them, the new ones yet. But I actually put number 6 elastics in them because if I'm fishing for roach shallow, or down the edge. So say you're fishing a venue where you're catching roach in really short, you can actually fish to hand.
I'd be interested to see if he means that F1 one-piece kit though, or F1 two-piece kit.
Yeah, well, either. You can use them for both. Obviously, the disadvantage is I use little plastic connectors on my light elastics. So obviously the bore sizes in the short F1 or the number, you know, the top kit, which is an F1 top 2, the bores are a bit bigger. So it depends on what connector you use for your light elastics. It would have to be the sort of decent size to stop it going up into the actual internal bush. But apart from that, you could use either for silverfish fishing. Not a problem at all. A lot of the people that ask me say, Des, look, I want to do some silverfish fishing. I say to them, buy an F1 top two. And they're like, why? I said, because when it gets warm again and you want to use that for F1 in carp, just take the elastic out and then you can start fishing like with carp again. Mm-hmm. It gives you that option to go surface fishing in the winter or lighter elastics in the winter. And then in the summer months, again, when it warms up, you can just take your light elastics out and start fishing with your 13s and 11s and stuff like that through it. That's what I always try and say to people, unless they're like a proper, you know, unless they want a proper match kit. I like match kits personally for surface fishing because I like that whippiness. I like that sort of flexibility in the end because it's a bit more a bush.
Jerry Ellis says, can you do a live chat every day this week as I'm 3 days into 10 days of isolation after getting COVID and I'm bored as flip?
No.
Sorry you've got COVID, but no. In the new year, we will be doing them one a week, aren't we?
Oh, it is actually on charge because last time we had two issues with the thing going flat, didn't we, the iPad?
We're going to try and do one, maybe not once a week, but certainly once a fortnight in the new year.
We will definitely be doing this. We've had a lot on at the moment with obviously the new polls and God knows what else we've been doing. And we will be doing it. Well, I think we're trying to do them on a Monday.
Yeah.
I wonder who said it then.
But it's either a Monday or Friday, isn't it? Because it's when you're not out filming.
We might leave it till Friday. Monday's an option because Monday's not a good day for most people. But yeah, we're going to try and do it on a Monday or a Friday. We've got
plenty of people watching today, though. So,
yeah.
Not the end of the world.
We will definitely be doing it, but we don't know what days we will be doing it.
Yeah.
Simple as that.
And just on that one.
I can't believe how many times I get asked on the bank.
I was really shocked
how well that's gone down.
It is amazing because we can do all these fancy edited videos and stuff, and yet something as simple as this is really popular. It just shows, doesn't it? Any updates on the availability of F1 Dark and fractures on the continent? Now, I was in the actual HQ the other day, and there was a lot of F1 Dark and fractures and stuff like that heading out into Europe. So they are finally getting on top of it.
I actually had a meeting at Preston 2 weeks ago, and obviously I speak to Ian, who's the manager at Sonny Bates, and I said, how is it? And believe me, he used to have some hair. He actually had more hair in me, and he hasn't now, because it has been
the biggest nightmare.
It's been an absolute nightmare. And I had a guy message me a few weeks ago and said, Des, can you send me a bag of match method mix? I will pay whatever you want for it. And to Italy or something. I said, well, that ain't going to happen. But that has been
a total cluster thing, hasn't it?
Complete disaster, believe you me. And honestly,
but apparently they're getting there with it.
Starting now to go through. So hopefully, for all of you guys in Europe, you will be seeing it very, very shortly. Or we hope. It is happening. It's happening.
It is. They were doing it the other day when I was there.
Ian actually smiled when I asked him the other day. So that means it's getting better.
What on that? He's basically spent a year trying to get that sorted. Amazing, really. Probably longer. I'm just getting back into pole fishing. What pole would you recommend for fishing commercial waters? Cheers and Merry Christmas to you all. That's from Paul Garner.
Thanks, Paul. If you're getting back into pole fishing, if you're a match angler, if you want to do a few matches as well, I would try and go stay away from maybe a margin because you might mark. That's a good starting pole, but. If you want to go out and sort of better yourself a little bit, then try and get a 13 meter pole. So the X10, maybe the X20, that would probably be a really good starting pole for you because you can fish up to sort of 13, 14 meters, which, like I said, especially what you've got to remember as well is if you go winter fishing, if you go out in the colder months, then you're going to want a longer pole. Because obviously the fish move away from the bank and that will give you the option of maybe fishing 13 meters and stuff like that. So if you do want to go out in the colder months and you know that, I would try and push yourself to probably an X20. You know, if you can afford to do it. If you're just going to want to get back into pole fishing and you're just going on your local commercial in the summer, you're not bothered about fishing in the winter, then a margin pole would do you proud. But if you want to, you know, try and push yourself if you can. Try and get up to like a 13 meter pole. So the X10, X20. definitely be the one.
Nice. This is quite a cool question. Lee says, not a question regarding the range, but the material. Do you guys think there will ever be a material better than carbon for rods and poles?
Bloody hell.
I know.
Well, if there is, we won't find out about it for several years.
Yeah, it'll be a long time. I think we'll be I think we'll be in the box in the ground before new material.
I'll be daisy pushing by then.
There's always something in there because at the end of the day, 40, 50 years ago, they were using split cane, weren't they? So.
Yeah, I don't know. That's a trip of difficulty. There ain't nothing out there at the moment, put it that way.
Mm.
I mean, you think about it. If you think a 16 meter, it's like a 40 foot piece of carbon.
Yeah.
Bloody amazing.
That is amazing,
really. Absolutely amazing that you can fish 16 meters, strike, and it is mind boggling. We've taken that for granted for a long time, haven't we? But when you actually think, you know, when I used to load lorries up for a living with a forklift, I used to think, that truck's 40 foot long. My pole's longer than that. Well, I'm holding it like, you hear people going along the venues now, if you've got a few ramblers and that going past you, they're like, hey?
Yeah, how does that even?
How's that possible? But yeah,
I think for the next few years, obviously poles all get stiffer, but they're stiff anyway. They'll probably get a bit more durable, won't they? A bit more robust.
Yeah. No one really knows. They're working on it, aren't they? Like everything. There's people out there, a lot clever, much cleverer than what I am.
4 years ago, when we were doing the XS 90, we'd have all been sat here saying, how are we going to do better than this?
Well, this is the thing. This is what I tried to get through to everybody. The improvements, you know, are big. In pole design, it's big, whichever way you look at it. It might not be big to some people that pick a pole up in the shop and think, well, actually, yeah, it's a bit different. But honestly, an improvement in poles now to get that is big. It really is.
Yeah. I just bought an Edge Monster margin pole. Now is my question. Can I put any size of elastic in the top kit? That's from
as long as it fits into that internal bush, put what you want into it.
Yeah.
You can swing. Well, no, I'm not going to say that. But that
pole's plenty strong.
I've got some 19 Dura there. I mean, that is proper angry elastic. And that, if get it in there, it won't be a problem. Will not be a problem. So any 19 elastics, 20 elastics, not a problem. Some people I know have actually cut the top kits back.
I did because I was bagging up at 5 meters on pace the other year, and I made some nice little strong Edge Monster top kits, cut them right back. And
some people have put bigger bushes in again, so they can put like stupid elastics. I call them stupid elastics because I don't use them, but.
In Europe, like a 4 mil elastic is common because they're fishing for big fish.
They're just crazy. And in Belgium, they use absolutely unbelievable elastics.
Yeah, it's all relative, isn't it? We're messing around with 1 pound F1s, they're catching 50 pound sturgeon in some waters.
10 kilo carp swinging them.
Yeah, so. Right, just a few left, Des, before we get back to work. What's the difference between the UK Superium poles and the Euro poles? We do a full range of European poles now, don't we?
Yeah, I've had nothing to do with the European poles. Nothing at all.
They're bloody lovely, they are.
They're made different because they've got a different, like we were just saying about elastics and stuff.
Well, I mean, 30 meters for a start, aren't they?
13 meters anyway. Their top kits are normally longer. A lot of venues in Europe are much deeper than where we fish. They're like, I think the top kits in Europe are normally about 3.6. That's a lot different to ours. Average 2.4 on a normal top kit. Theirs are, I think they used to be 3.6 or 3.4. Joe will find out. So there's a lot of different involvement in that because, like I said, a lot of the guys fish deep canals, deep rivers, even their commercials in Italy. When I go to Italy, or I've done to it, unfortunately, I've missed Italy so much because of the COVID stuff. A lot of the venues in Italy are 10 to 15, you know, to 15 foot deep. I fished a couple of venues, they're 6 meters, 8 meters. You chuck a Mefford feeder out, you can have a cup of tea and a fag by the time your feeder hits the bottom. So there's a lot more involvement where we don't do that in England. You know, we just stick another joint up where they want longer number three sections.
Oh, I'm trying to find a length out for you.
But obviously, we've got consultants all over Europe, you know. Obviously, they will work around what they've seen, what we have, like the new Superiums, and they'll work with that. But they are. It is very, very different, as in top kits and stuff
different
like that.
Different actions and everything, aren't they?
Yeah, and obviously, if you have longer top kits, then you have to rearrange the rest of the pole to suit those top kits, because where the joints go, like we've already spoke about, makes a huge, huge difference. And if my head was involved in that and all this, I'd probably be in a straitjacket, to be perfect.
It'd fall off, wouldn't it, your head?
It'd be coming off completely. So yeah, thankfully I don't get involved in that, in that respect.
That Euro 3000 that we do is unbelievable.
Yeah. But it will be 13 meter pole. It's built. This is what we said earlier. It's built to make a 13 and a 16 is, well, I don't say ridiculous, but well, it is ridiculous. They've never really done it. It's virtually impossible to do, to make it good. That's why we have that's why in Europe they have a 13 meter. In Europe, it's easy. 13 meters finished. So they can work at the best 13 meter pole possible, where we have to work to make the best 16 meter pole for the top of the range poles.
Yeah.
Very different.
Trevor says he's got a response margin. Is it worth him upgrading to the new Superium margin?
A response margin to Superium.
That's a great pole, that response margin anyway, isn't it?
Yeah. I think if you went and seen it, Trevor, there would be a difference. And you probably actually fall in love with it.
The only thing that's obviously quite nice on the new one, we've got a 10 meter extension this time.
Yeah, and it is nice. It is nice.
Yeah.
But I think you'd have to take your pole in.
The response one's good though. It's a really nice pole.
It is a nice bit of kit, that. I've actually got some of the sections up in my little rod thing here, actually. But yeah, I think you'd fall in love with it. If you took yours in and picked the new one up, I think you'd be like, actually. I've got to get myself one of them.
Yeah, that's only you can make that decision there, Trevor. Yeah. I'm not going to stay here and say it's miles better than the old one, because it is, but it's that other one's good. Yeah,
definitely.
Right.
And I've got my new Celsius. Look at, I've got to bring this up. This is the absolute nuts.
Have you got the joggers yet?
I ain't got the joggers on because they're too hot.
Too hot for indoor use, aren't
they? Too hot. And I went, I've never had Celsius joggers in that. And I got some fruits, it's just come in. And I got to say, it's the absolute nuts. I went to Tunnel Bar on Saturday. It was half frozen. And I do suffer with my hands. I have suffered my hands the last year or so. But I'm not kidding you. That stuff.
That is an edge. Having that clothing is an edge.
Yeah, it is brilliant. I got the hoodie. It is absolutely beautiful. Because you've got like an inner, even on the joggers, you sort of put your hand in the pocket and it's got like another
layer, isn't it?
Layer. Bloody good.
Oh, there's me. It's raining and I've got all my windows open outside to let the flies out.
Well, at least they might come out now. Now it's raining.
I hope so. They need to bugger off, but otherwise I'd be keeping the neighbours up all night. Right. I think, is the cart pole usable at 16 metres? The excess is not great.
Yeah, it's a big improvement. Big improvement.
And it's obviously, there's got to be a bit of give and take, because at the end of the day, it's a super strong cart pole, isn't it?
Yeah, and we put, when we were out testing it, we put a match kit, because obviously the cart pole doesn't come with a match kit. But if you put a match kit on it, or an F1-2, or an F1 section, which is the top two, it makes a big difference. You know, big difference.
Mm.
But yeah, it's, of course, the improvement is big, and you need to go and have a look at it. We're not telling you lies. There is a big improvement of all the poles.
Yeah, but you're just never going to get a cart pole that's as stiff as the next 90. It's just not possible. No.
It is a four-blade cart pole. When we design a cart pole, we design a cart pole.
Mm.
Even though all the poles in the range are capable of cart, you know, I carry one pole with me. I carry an X90. I carried an XS90 before that. And I carried an M90 before that. There has been odd occasion when I'm thinking I need a cart pole, because this thing is doing the business, but I'm like, actually it's beyond its means. Because what I'm trying to do with it, it's like, Jesus Christ, I get more, you know, really aggressive. And you're like, don't lose it. You're fishing like, you know, the most expensive pole at Preston do. And that's the reality of it. That's when you've got to maybe say, I need a carp pole. And I remember, you know, Topper Manor last year, I fished Topper Manor. And to be honest, I needed a carp pole for what you're trying to do with that. Even though that my XS90 done it, I was like, I don't need that pole. I need something that I can, because it is that sort of fishing. It was like massive weights, thick elastics. Even though the top kits were capable of, the pole was capable of doing it. I caught 400 and some odd pound one day, but I was just thinking, for how far I'm fishing out, and what I'm doing, I need a carp pole. No, so it is. But going back to your question, you need to honestly go out and have a look at these new poles in the shops. It is, we can tell you until we're black and blue in the face, but the reality of it is when you pick them up, you will know exactly what me and Joe have been talking about. I'm not just on this, but on films that we've done. I think you've got a film coming out, Joe, haven't you? You've got a film coming out, aren't you, with the one about all the poles?
Yeah, we did one where you go for everything. That's been out now. And then we're doing one for each individual one, but obviously it just takes time. I'm busy at the minute doing Des versus Lee, Christmas special.
Even go there.
Yeah, don't give the game away.
Not giving the game away. I just couldn't use my fingers.
Well, your hand's cold, mate. Anyway.
See that, ladies and gentlemen? That didn't go down very well, did it?
It went fine for me. I didn't have to have cold hands.
Poor old Zolt, he couldn't even press the button on the camera.
He's a bit of a
Well, considering he's hungry, you'd think, like, not be funny, the winters they get.
No.
He's a bit of a tame man, I reckon. He's not what I thought he was gonna be.
Well, he was a florist before. Mark says, is it possible that Preston would do another run of the absolute carbon?
Absolute carbon box.
Beat box.
I don't know. I honestly don't know. I don't think so, personally. I think the amount of man hours produced, because that's what it comes down to at the end of the day, the amount of money that was spent in man hours producing that box was ridiculous. It really was, because we always say it. I've always said it with Preston. The boxes you see on the market, Preston Innovation boxes, they are produced from drawings. They are not produced in a factory and someone goes on and says, I'll have that box there with my colours on it.
Happens a lot.
Yeah, they are produced from guys on a CAD machine. Chris.
Telford, yeah.
People like that, Todd. They all the knuckles, things like that. It is been produced from scratch. And to produce that carbon box from scratch I love it. I mean, I've still got mine and I could probably use that until the end of time. I might have to change a couple of knuckles on it where they've worn out. But I just think the amount of money that cost the company.
It won't happen, Des. It's not happening.
No.
If you've got one, it'd be worth a few quid in a few years, that beauty. Mm. And I tell you what, they're still going strong even now. I've got one, you've got one.
Yeah.
Very few.
They're mega, mega, mega. But like it becomes a time where it's just gone a bit too far. And that's probably what basically happened, really.
Yeah.
The money, the actual involvement in money, people's time spent doing that, where that time could have been spent doing.
Yeah, it was a showpiece product, wasn't it?
It was a showpiece. And people now understand it. They understand how good they are. And everybody wants one. yeah.
Right, that's an hour and a half, Des. I think that's a nice part to end on.
It's dinner time, so that's perfect for me.
So Des versus Lee. Des versus Lee, you two.
Yeah.
That's gonna be Christmas Eve.
Yeah.
There's gonna be a competition on that to win some nice stuff. There's gonna be products. Competitions on all the videos over the next few weeks, so that'll be really cool. And I just want to say to everyone, thanks for subscribing and supporting the channel. It's been really, really good over the last few weeks, so thanks to everyone for that.
Yeah, and thanks for the support, you know, everybody, not just me, everybody, you know, social media is massive nowadays, we know that. I get loads of support, so anybody who follows me and everybody else out there, it means a lot, you know, when you It really does. I, you know, we all write the truth. So yeah, have a, well, if we don't see, if I don't see you before, have a great Christmas, because it ain't far off now, is it? I've got to do some shopping actually, because I haven't done bugger all, as per normal. But have a great Christmas. Like I said, like Joe said, thanks for the support. And nice to be some great prizes. I think there's some great prizes giveaway to come
up. Some good prizes. There's no polls to give away, unfortunately. I'm working on that one for everybody.
So yeah, thanks again. Thanks for all the questions.
Maybe if we get to 100,000 subscribers, which is a long way off, I will say, maybe we can give a poll away. Who knows?
Well, maybe. Won't be this year, I don't think.
Oh, well, definitely won't be this year.
But yeah, the Q&As will be back next year, without a doubt.
Mm-hmm.
So think of some real good questions, and I'll try and answer them as truthfully and, you know, correct as I can in my little man cave, if you like.
Yep.
What are you
doing much fishing over Christmas?
Yeah, I've got a little bit. I need some time down as well, to be honest. I have a few days off. I say that and then I go fishing, don't I? Some always crops up. Oh, we've got a swordfish match there. I'll do that. Mm. Yeah, I'm out on the 27th, 28th. I got the third. I got a swordfish match at Riddings Lake on the third. I got into that. Some of that'll be okay. I think some of it'll be rock hard, but that's fishing the winter. Just carry on as normal, really.
Chub starts for me now. The river's had a bit of a flush through. I can't wait.
Yeah, I would like to go on the Stour. I would like to go back on the Stour before the Christmas, but I don't know if I'll be able to make it. But yeah, it's just flat out normal stuff. Tying plenty of rigs, plenty of hooks. So it's just ongoing, really. Never stops. So that's it, really. But yeah, like I said, Q&A's be back after Christmas, without a doubt. We'll let you know. Well, Joe will let you know when that's all kicking off. And I'll probably be a stone heavier again by then because of the amount of food I'll be eating over Christmas.
I'm going to eat a lot of food. I have been eating a lot of food, and I'm going to keep eating a lot.
I will try not to, but...
Paul's just said they sent me a Facebook friend request. I don't really do Facebook, Paul, so don't be offended if I don't accept you. I've probably got 1,000 on there.
Yeah, that's a real good point. I get loads of friends requests.
I only do Facebook for work, unfortunately. I don't use it at home. So
yeah, I don't write private stuff on my Facebook page. It is like Joe, so mostly work and what you guys want
to
know.
I do need to switch off because obviously we're constantly in doing all this stuff.
Don't be offended if you don't get something back.
Yeah.
So, well, there you go, guys. I hope you've enjoyed that little rundown of all the poles and stuff and the spares, top kits and that. It's all going to help. And have a lovely Christmas.
Yeah, have a good Christmas, everyone.
Having a happy new year.
I will probably be on before Christmas to just explain about the competitions and stuff. But it will only be a quick live catch-up sort of thing. So.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you very much and take care of yourselves.